If asked to determine the in-behavior or long-run behavior of a polynomial function, it's possible to determine the in-behavior just by knowing the degree of the polynomial and the sign of the leading coefficient. But before we start, let's review what in-behavior or long-run behavior is. The in-behavior describes the value of the function, or the y-value, as x approaches the left, or approaches negative infinity, and approaches the right, or approaches positive infinity. First, let's consider when the degree is even. And we'll assume that the terms of the polynomial are in descending order, so our polynomial will have degree n, and the leading coefficient will be a. So if n is greater than or equal to 2 and even, and the leading coefficient is positive or greater than 0, then as x approaches infinity, or as we move right, f of x approaches positive infinity, or the y values increase without bound. So looking at the graph, as x approaches positive infinity, we'd be moving right along the function. As we move right along the function, notice how the y values or function values are going up or increase without bound. Therefore, f of x approaches positive infinity. As x approaches negative infinity, f of x also approaches positive infinity. So as x approaches negative infinity, or we move left along the function, notice how the y values or function values also increase without bound, approaching positive infinity. And this will always be the case when the degree is greater than or equal to 2, even, and the leading coefficient is positive. So for example, if we have a function like f of x equals 5x to the 8th minus 6x to the 5th plus 3x squared minus 2, the in-behavior of this function will be the same as the in-behavior described here. And we can determine this just by looking at the degree of the polynomial and the sign of the leading coefficient. Next, if n is greater than or equal to 2 and even, but the leading coefficient is negative or less than 0, then as x approaches positive infinity, f of x approaches negative infinity. So as we move right along the graph, notice how the y values or function values decrease without bound, approaching negative infinity. And as x approaches negative infinity, f of x also approaches negative infinity. So as we move left, or as x approaches negative infinity, the function values or y values also decrease without bound, approaching negative infinity. And again, this will always be true when we have a polynomial function with an even degree and a negative leading coefficient. So for example, the function f of x equals negative 0.25 x to the 4th plus 5x to the 3rd minus 200 will have the same in behavior as described here, and we know this just because the degree is even, the leading coefficient is negative. Now let's consider in behavior when we have a polynomial function and the degree is odd. If n is greater than or equal to 1 and odd with a positive leading coefficient, then as x approaches positive infinity, f of x approaches positive infinity. So as we move right along the graph, or as x approaches positive infinity, notice how the function values or y values are increasing without bound. Therefore, f of x is approaching positive infinity. And as x approaches negative infinity, f of x approaches negative infinity. So as we move left along the graph, notice how the y values or function values are decreasing without bound, approaching negative infinity. This will always be the case when the degree is odd and the leading coefficient is positive. So for example, if we have the function f of x equals 2x to the 7th minus 2x to the 6th plus 7x to the 5th minus 3x squared minus 1, again, because the degree is odd and the leading coefficient is positive, the in behavior will be the same as described here. And the last case is when n is greater than or equal to 1 and odd, and a is negative or less than 0, then as x approaches positive infinity, f of x approaches negative infinity. So as we move right along the graph, notice how the function values or y values are decreasing without bound, approaching negative infinity. And as x approaches negative infinity, f of x approaches positive infinity. So as we move left along the graph, notice how the function values or y values are increasing in that bound, approaching positive infinity. This will always be the case when the degree is odd and the leading coefficient is negative. So if we have f of x equals negative 10x to the fifth plus 4x to the fourth minus 3, this function will have the same end behavior as described here. Because the degree is odd, the leading coefficient is negative. Of course, whenever you're asked to describe the end behavior and you're not sure, it's best to graph the function and analyze the graph. I hope you found this summary helpful.